In this problem, we're given information about three definite integrals. Now, to determine the value of the definite integral of negative 3 times f of x plus 2 times g of x minus h of x from 2 to 14. Notice for all the given information, the upper and lower limits of integration are the same, but this first definite integral involves f of x, the second involves g of x, and the third involves h of x. So to find the value of this definite integral here, we'll be applying two properties of definite integrals. Where first, if we have the integral of a constant k times f of x from a to b, we can factor out this k, so this is equal to k times the definite integral of f of x from a to b. And then second, if we have the integral of f of x plus or minus g of x from a to b, we can break this up into separate definite integrals, where we have the integral of f of x from a to b plus or minus the integral of g of x from a to b. So going back to our example, because we have a sum or difference of three different functions here, we'll write this as a sum and difference of three definite integrals. So this is equal to the definite integral of negative 3 times f of x from 2 to 14 plus the integral of 2 times g of x from 2 to 14, and then minus the integral of h of x from 2 to 14. And now from here, we can factor out the constant negative 3 and the constant positive 2. So we'd have negative 3 times the integral of f of x from 2 to 14 plus 2 times the integral of g of x from 2 to 14 minus the integral of h of x from 2 to 14. Well, we know the integral of f of x from 2 to 14 is equal to 28, so here we'd have negative 3 times 28 plus 2 times the integral of g of x from 2 to 14 is equal to 39, so we have 2 times 39, and then finally minus the integral of h of x from 2 to 14, which is equal to 8. So here we have negative 3 times 28 equals negative 84 plus 2 times 39, that's 78, minus 8 is equal to negative 14. I hope you found this helpful.